We're in the middle of a 100-mile canoe fishing expedition through the Adirondack Mountains in New York. The trip has been much more difficult than anticipated. We've grinded through almost a dozen grueling portages over rough terrain, paddled through a snowstorm, and braved icy waters during a Class 3 rapid almost a mile long. Luckily, we've also caught plenty of fish along the way.
Oh yeah, dude. Oh, it's a dinosaur.
In the fourth and final part of our journey, the fish are biting again, but we'll face a new challenge as our portaging system takes a turn for the broken.
And our worst fear has been realized. The Railblazer Sea Tug car finally gave way after more abuse than I think one's ever been put through.
Then I make a crucial mistake that costs us precious time, and we realize we aren't getting out of this place on time.
We're not gonna make it with this headwind.
Hey Mark, what do you think? Keep going?
Basically, we're not gonna finish today.
Alright, so morning of day 7. Tonight will be our last night here, and to kind of treat ourselves, we're making our last good meal. Ben DeShaney is making pancakes, and we've got maple syrup.
They're tall over there, yeah.
Oh yeah.
So it's morning of day 7, and we're at mile 69 of the trip. Hey yo. And basically, we're not gonna finish today. So this is day 7, there's no way we'll finish. So we're definitely gonna be here for an 8th day tomorrow. That means we've got about 30 miles to go in 2 days. And today we've got 2 portages. So that's a lot of ground to cover based on our historic performance thus far.
Another freaking portage.
Gonna start the morning off with a nice little workout.
Uphill again. Let's keep things interesting.
Hey, y'all be careful. That left wheel on that sea tub looks real rough. These roots are taking their toll.
And then the cart broke. So...
And our worst fear has been realized. The Railblazer Sea Tug car finally gave way after more abuse than I think one's ever been put through. 400 to 500 pounds of canoeing gear over about 7-8 portages, rough terrain, rocks, roots, and finally one kicked the bucket. I'll be honest, I thought it was gonna happen way sooner than this. Pretty impressed, but that's a problem. The only option is to hopscotch the canoes. The four of us work to get the one canoe up, use each other to help lift, and then come back and put the cart on this one, and just then we're doing 2 trips. And let's just help lift it, make sure over these rocks and stuff we're not putting it through abuse so we don't break another one. Lift. There's a big rock right there we have to lift over. Lift, lift, lift.
Hold on.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Easily cartable, they said.
All right, got the first canoe to the end. Now we're back to get the second one, do it all over again.
Up, 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 higher, higher, higher.
My legs are like jello, man. I'm out of fuel. All right.
Oh. 1.1 miles, the fully loaded canoe on rough terrain, twice. It's funny, like, Just another day in the Adirondacks now. Getting used to it. No time to dilly-dally. Gotta get going.
Dude, where are my rods?
Ben! So, we just got done with that portage. Got about 500 yards off the bank. And I realized I was missing something pretty important. My fishing rods.
That guy, man.
They're back at camp. Mark here, out of the kindness of his heart, has agreed to walk back with me.
I don't know why I went to get the rods with Rob. If the cameras weren't on, I probably wouldn't.
It's probably a few miles. Rex and Ben are over there fishing, having a good time, laughing. And we're hiking again.
You going?
Yeah. Yep.
All right, so we made it past where the portage started, but since we didn't bring a canoe, now we're having to walk around the lake that we paddled across this morning. I'm sure Rex is back there wearing the fish out. We didn't catch any fish yesterday, but now that I'm not up there with my rods, I'm sure they're biting like crazy.
Oh no, just a smallie.
Rob and Mark are fetching the rods they left at camp. So me and Ben are forced to fish. Just killing time, just fishing.
There they are. All right, now I just gotta walk back through the woods with fishing rods in my hand. Damn, missed the gnarly part. And we made it back. I wonder if Rex caught any fish while we were gone. You catch any more while we were gone?
We caught another one on the craw.
Got two smallies?
Yeah, right there. So two smallies while you guys were out frolicking in the wilderness.
Yeah. That was a long walk. I'm jealous you caught fish. So we're trying to find the next portage. We thought we were supposed to take a right around into a cove. So we just did that and realized that it wasn't a cove. We just paddled around an island. We basically are literally going in circles. And we're behind schedule. I just had to walk all the way back to get my rods with Mark. And so we don't really have time to be doing donuts. Yeah, get out the map, man. Let's check the map again. See if we can figure it out.
This is it, so. I think this is it.
I was so lost. Again.
All right, Mark and Ben think they figured out where we gotta go, so we're just gonna commit to it. Hopefully it's right.
Yeah, Ben was the navigator. I was just over there eating trail mix.
It's a lot harder without GPS, man. 2016, we're spoiled nowadays.
Ooh.
Nice, dude. I got that.
Nice, dude.
What you got, man? Yeah. Smallmouth. Nice. That Bugs Radix Shad, man. Never seen that before. That Texas special.
I'm gonna let you go.
Smooth release.
There's two on the landing. Hey, dude, those are my gloves.
Rex kept taking my gloves. I only have so many gloves.
Fish, fish, fish. Nice, another smallie. Nice. Just getting kind of down, didn't catch fish yesterday. Just went through that portage, got lost, and as soon as we found where we're going.
Oh, got one, got one.
Oh, Rex is on. Nice, jumping up. And both Rex and I hooked up. Rex is on a fish right now.
We're getting into fish as soon as we hit the portage. Man, I need
some
pliers, man.
Oh, nice, dude, man. Dude, this is a good size.
Nice one, man.
The last portage of our trip might as well have been a pleasant stroll through the countryside compared to most of the ones we've encountered.
Dude, this looks steep.
No Nobody's mad. Nobody's complaining. I think we're all just numb.
Sean,
I thought his hook set was a joke. Rob told him to catch a fish, and he caught a fish.
It's a largemouth, is it?
Largemouth?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a largemouth.
On the crank.
Yeah. Nice. First largemouth of the trip.
Just so I can get a face.
We began to pick up the pace as the sun raced for the horizon, but when we rounded the corner onto Middle Saranac Lake, I immediately knew we were in trouble.
Double time, boys!
I could see the fear in Rex's eyes.
Hey, Mark, what do you think? Keep going?
All right, hey, the wind is way too rough, right in our face. It's sketchy. We're all getting splashed. It's close to dark. We don't want to be wet going into camp at dark. We're just going to turn around and kind of emergency camp, not get to our campsite. Just had to make that up in the morning.
That sucked, man.
That sucked.
Just get up here and call an Uber.
Yeah. I think Uber has like a boat service.
One week in the Adirondacks has literally changed me as a person. I knew going into this that it was gonna be tough, but I grossly underestimated exactly the kind of challenges and obstacles we were gonna face on this trip. Physically, this was the most demanding week of my life, without a doubt. And you know, it's strange that I'm not mad about it. You know, I feel like I've gone soft, like our society has gone soft. There's this emphasis on, you know, making things easier, less work, faster travel times. And I feel like by doing that, we've kind of lost some of the things that made us human, some of the things that really pushed our species forward. And spending a week out here and getting back to some of that, getting back to the physical, manual way of life, this is the sort of trip that changes and shapes who you become as a human being, and I feel like only for the better. I've pushed myself harder than I ever would have thought I could have gone, and I made it. And there's something extremely empowering about that. I feel like when I get back home and I'm presented with some small problem, some small obstacle in my life, it's gonna seem like a cakewalk, it's gonna seem like a joke compared to some of the moments on this trip. When I get back and my friends ask me, why did you do it? I'm gonna tell them because it made me a better person. I'm gonna tell them because I learned something about myself that I could not have learned any other way. I learned that I'm stronger than I think. I learned that you can put four guys together that barely know each other, put them under some of the most intense pressure of their lives, and they will band together and help each other get through it. I've learned about the importance of remembering where we came from. This is most definitely a week that I'll remember for the rest of my life. But for now, I'm gonna go help the guys cook dinner, get some sleep, and finish this trip up in the morning. Hopefully we can catch a few fish along the way. And I am very ready to get home and get a hot shower.
Like, I know what it means to work hard from morning till nighttime. So you go to sleep.
Right.
And then do it all over again the next day.
And again.
And that's how that's how my grandparents lived.
Yep.
That's how your grandparents lived.
Yep.
Before we had all these amenities, before we had all these like luxuries. And that's the perspective I walk away with. Like, I have an understanding of what it means to really work hard.
Right.
The forks. No. The last two forks.
No. Do you see what's happening? I can't see.
All right, guys, so here we are on day 8. It's our final day here in the Adirondacks. We've got about 15 miles to complete our 100-mile trip. No portages today is the good news, but we still have a lot of water to cover, so we've got to get to it. Hopefully, we can catch a few fish along the way. Should have known that it wasn't going to be totally smooth sailing on the last day. Sounds like we've got some rapids up ahead, and it sounds like our options are either to run the rapids or use the locks to get through this. All right, so there's a really hard turn at the bottom of those rapids, and we're going to be going really fast, and with Rex and I up front, our draws are not really up to par. We don't want to risk going in this close to the finish line, so we're just going to hit the locks instead. None of us have ever been through the locks, so it'll be a cool experience. Let's check it out, see how this thing works. Which way is downstream? What do we do? Yeah, the locks in Galveston have motors to do this. Yeah, that's the wicket. Who knew?
And then when the pressure gets low enough, you guys will be able to open it.
Yeah. Hey, I just realized, I gotta get across. Fish. Fish on. Nice, smallie. Looks like a good one. No! Lost them right at the boat. Fish. Nice. Not a big pike, but still fun nonetheless, especially since I just watched him take my bait.
Funny, you know, we came here looking for fish, and I think we found a whole lot more. And the fish were just a bonus.
And there it is, Saranac Lake, New York. The end of our journey.
Do tip. Tip it, tip it. Ah. Oh.
This entire trip was so far out of my comfort zone. But I think that's why I did it. I mean, people don't do that anymore.
What a week. I feel like a different person. I feel like I don't belong in society anymore.
I smell like I don't belong in society.
Yeah, they're not going to let me in a restaurant. We might have to walk through a drive-thru.
I think this trip was probably one of the better ones of my life. I think part of that was the guys involved. But, the suffering definitely made it more memorable.
Woo!
My feet hurt so bad.
This is a good spot.
8 days later, we left New York different men than when we arrived. The Adirondack Mountains had left their mark on us like so many canoeists before us. We came looking for fish and footage, but left with experience, wisdom, and an inner strength none of us knew we possessed. But above all else, we yearned for the next adventure.
This is my reaction to Rob filming instead of paddling.
It was cold. Like I'd wake up numb and wonder if I was dead cold. Colder than a polar bear's toenails. Colder than an Eskimo's eyeballs.
More of a canoeer than an angler? Like, Robert's not much of a canoeer or an angler.
I think this might mean more time for fishing. Ben's shaking his head.
This is definitely the first time I've ever gotten to poop while looking at the snow and enjoying the forest.
Well, tell me what to do. Do I look at it or not look at it? Hey, how you do? I'll squeeze your face.
Is it on?
Yeah, no.
Can it hear me?
Put this canoe on my back like it's my motherfucking last name. We in the Adirondacks, I'm not sure why we came. Wasn't for the glory, but it might have been for the fame. I'm not sure, but I think Ben DeShaney's to blame.